Hi everyone, I'm Kylie the Jellyfish. This video will be a part of a continuous series that I'm doing on my channel. It's going to be a playlist right here, all about how to color your hair for beginners. This video is going to be about how to prevent color from fading. Let me just go ahead and get right into it.
Your hair will always fade if you have semi-permanent hair dye.
Stop thinking that you can have color for more than a month, because if you do, you're very lucky. Just know the color will always fade faster than you want it to, and there's nothing you can do about it. Alright, thank you guys so much for watching. Aww. Just kidding, there is stuff you can do about it. Number one on my list, Color Safe Shampoo and Color Safe Conditioner. There are too many out there now for you to not know that you should have one. If you can find something like Matrix, Biolage, Redken, Paul Mitchell's a really good one. R & Co. is amazing. Kerastase, Sebastian, Wella, Pureology. Pureology all the way, man. I love Pureology. So these are all just great brands where you have to pay attention though. If it says color safe on the bottle, it's color safe. If it doesn't say color safe anywhere, it's just not color safe. No brand is ever going to say that they're not color safe. So just look for color safe. And another tip for preventing color fading is to only use conditioner whenever you can. I actually have a video right here. This video is about how to stop using shampoo on your hair. Shampoo is not always necessary to wash your hair. There's also cleansing conditioners out there, and I would rather you watch that video than me re-explain everything here. You don't have to shampoo every time you need your hair to be clean, especially if your hair is blonde. Your blonde hair is probably drier, therefore it will absorb moisture a little bit faster than the rest of your hair that might be healthy like this side. Another thing you can do to prevent hair color from fading out is using color locking leave-in products, like leave-in conditioners or leave-in sprays. So I don't really have any particular brands. I know that there's one by Wella called Color Brilliance. It's in a like pale red bottle. There's one by Pulp Riot that I haven't tried but looks really good. Just look up products that prevent color from fading out, like leave-in products. And avoid getting your hair wet in general. When cuticles open up and close, hair is based off of pH level. A lot of people think that cold water seals the cuticle and hot water opens the cuticle. There are hairstylists out there that argue about this. Technically, there is no science backing it up. You can do your own research. You can tell me in the comments if I'm wrong. The misconception came from the fact that pores on your face really do open with heat and close with cold. So everyone assumed that cuticles on your hair are the same as pores on your face, which is absolutely not true. I mean, hair is made of keratin and pores are not. So why would you assume that they do the same thing with temperature? The reason why some people do think that cuticles will open up with heat or close with cold is because we put heat on hair to process hair when we put color in it. That is usually because color itself or lightener itself is heat activated, because it's the product that's working faster, not the hair opening up faster. If you put your hair under hot water, it's bad because if you put any heat on your hair, whether it's wet or dry heat, it's going to damage your hair, like flat ironing or curling your hair. That's going to damage it just as much as putting your head under a hot shower. So that's why we also tell you not to wash your hair with hot water. Hot dehydrates. That's just a fact. What does matter is pH level of the water. Water itself, in its most basic form, is a neutral pH level. When you look at the scale from alkaline to acidic, in the middle there is usually water, because water sits roughly at a 7. But that doesn't mean all waters are at the same pH level. You could see hundreds of YouTube videos on people testing the pH balance of different water bottles and showing how different they are. And yes, alkaline water is very good to drink, but alkaline water is very bad for your hair, because alkalinity opens the cuticle and acidity closes the cuticle. This is why AVC rinses, also known as apple cider vinegar, will close the hair down and give your hair shine. because it's sealing down that cuticle and locking whatever's in there in. A perm solution on the hair, you'll also know that the perm itself is opening up that cuticle. And then the second thing you use is an acidic rinse that will shut the cuticle back down to seal it in so that the perm stays curly. Avoid sunlight. Avoid sunlight at all costs. If you go out into the sun for long periods of time, wear a hat. If you don't like wearing hats, I get it. I hate wearing hats. And use UV protective products. The brand Arn Co. is a brand that is vegan, cruelty-free, and sulfate and paraben-free. It also all has built-in heat protection and UV protection. Sebastian Color Brilliance Shine Spray? Shine Mist? I forgot what it's called. All of the products that I buy on Amazon for hair will be linked in my description under Amazon Favorites. But that doesn't mean everything I mention will be on Amazon. But UV protective products is like sunblock for your hair, and it will prevent your color from fading in sunlight. Going back to the alkalinity, if you're also out in sunlight, you might be at the beach or at the pool, don't dunk your head in water, because salt water is alkaline, so is chlorine. So chlorine and salt water will most definitely fade your color out. If you can, keep your head above water, put your hair up in a bun or a clip of some kind, and if not, just limit your time in the water. If you have the choice of going to the hair salon and getting your color done, or doing your color before or after a vacation, choose after the vacation so you don't ruin your color right away. If you're dyeing your hair a pastel color or a very pale, light, or bright color, like let's even say you're not going for pastel, but you're trying to make more product and you have dark pink and you want to make it a normal looking pink, you dilute that with conditioner, right? Well, the more conditioner you use, the less pigment is going into your hair, therefore the color will fade out faster. My final advice for preventing color fade is to use shampoos and conditioners with color depositing properties. And I know for a fact half of you have heard of Overtone. Overtone is a brand that sells daily conditioners, deep masks, and different forms of conditioner-based products that are semi-permanent color. And you could color your hair from blonde to pink with it, but it's also really good for maintaining the color. I'll tell you why I don't love Overtone. Overtone has been extremely difficult to remove for me. I've had people come in and they said that they used Overtone 8 months ago. 8 months ago, and I still could barely get their hair blonde. So she had like brown hair down to here, but then her tips were blonde. She had like blended highlights in there, but you can really see them because a lot of her hair was brown. She wanted purple hair. I had to foil her hair blonde first. It just lifted to periwinkle. I'm so lucky she didn't ask for blonde hair, right? She asked for purple hair. So I was able to get her purple that day, but I would never have been able to get her blonde, even though she used it only 8 months ago. Listen to other people's reviews on a product before using it and find out if it stays in the hair too long. Ion is sold at Sally Beauty Supply, but ignore it. Pretend it doesn't exist. Because it is the devil. I've seen blues, I've seen purples, and I've seen greens all turn green after you try to remove it. Yeah, like imagine having purple violet hair, and then it fades, and then it's like kind of dusty, but then you want to go blonde, and then you put foils in your hair, you take them out, and it's bright swamp green, and that color never goes away, it stays. And I'm not the first hairstylist to say this. I actually have a huge list of products that can be used to deposit color onto hair to enjoy your color. Tressa Watercolors Intense Shampoo. I actually have a video all about these. They're shampoos that deposit color into your hair and they're really awesome. Moroccan Oil Color Masks. So these are conditioners with a lot of color in them. They are really bright. I have one and it's teal. And I mean, it's just basically color at that point. It stains the bathtub if I just drop it and leave it there. Maria Nilla Color Refresh. This one is a good one. I mean, I love this product so much. I buy it from Cosmoprof, so I don't know if you could find it other than in salons. Joico Color Butter. This is a good one. I like Joico. Joico's pretty good. Lime Crime Hair Color Conditioner. I haven't used this one, but I've heard people like it. Just know that you can also just get semi-permanent hair dye and put it in a jar with conditioner, and you can make yourself a tint mask for at home. If you used semi-permanent to begin with, it's the same shit. You're just recoloring your hair in the shower. Okay, and so along with that, I am going to talk about how to remove color from hair. Take everything that I just said and flip it around to the opposite direction. Shampoo your hair a lot. Go out into the sunlight a lot. Dunk your head in a pool whenever you see a pool. Run through the ocean and whoosh your hair around in the salt water. Do whatever you can to do exactly what I just said not to do. Do it slowly over time. Don't expect to have pink hair and then have blonde hair the next day without bleaching it. I don't know a lot about color removers. It's almost impossible to find a color remover that isn't technically bleach. Technically bleach. And when it's technically bleach, just call it bleach. Like, I don't even care if it's like one molecule off from real bleach. If you're abrasively lifting hair with you're probably doing the same exact amount of damage as just using a low developer. There's a specific remover we have at work for demi-permanent color, and if you have a specific kind of color that you put in your hair, look up that color and how to remove that specific color, because every type of color has a different type of remover for it. Shampoo your hair all the time with clarifying shampoo. So my favorite one is Nioxin. This one removes chlorine from hair. It strips everything out of your hair. I can imagine very alkaline, but if you have any products in your cabinet already that don't say color safe, just shampoo the shit out of your hair with those. Make sure you use a very, very moisturizing conditioner afterwards. If you have deep conditioners or hair masks, use those instead of conditioner, but as long as anything says moisture, use it. Anything stripping your hair is stripping out a lot of moisture too, and you don't want to dry your hair out so much that it's gonna become so brittle that it then breaks off in the process. And also, anti-dandruff shampoo can typically be clarifying, but I have seen most recently there are new brands coming out claiming they have an anti-dandruff shampoo that is color safe. And so I don't really know how legit that is, but if it says color safe on it, obviously don't use that to strip your hair. I mean, obviously. Paul Mitchell Tea Tree, that's one that I know will really strip out color well. I've heard of DIY methods like using dish soap on your hair. That sounds real harsh, but I've done it. Pretty much works. There's another method with baking soda. I don't remember if I've ever used baking soda in my hair. I let my hair fade naturally. Do it slowly. Embrace the process of letting your hair fade. Enjoy the pastel stage, and then use corrective color theory. I had a separate video all about corrective color theory, so this one is gonna be mostly canceling out tones with the opposite color that you have. Great example of this is one time I was trying to go silver and I had peach hair. I put teal in conditioner, dime size amount of teal in a big bowl of conditioner, covered my entire hair with it, and it canceled out the peach and it left it silver. If your hair is green, use pink conditioner to cancel it out. If your hair is yellow, use lavender, but don't do that until the hair is at a pale enough stage. The ultimate thing that I like to do for hair is a bleach bath. A bleach bath is when you mix lightener with a very low developer with water. Now, you don't have to necessarily add the water, but it adds to the dilution process to make it a much more gentle process. If you have a lot of color to remove though, just do a little bit of lightener powder and then a lot of 10 volume. And it's gonna be really, really watery. Get some gloves on, put that on your hair, and then just watch it. Like, don't leave it on for a specific amount of time, just kind of let it happen, and you'll see the color slowly remove from your hair. I mean, I wouldn't leave it in the hair any longer than 40 minutes. Probably 25 to 30 minutes is gonna be good, and rinse it out in the shower, and if you need to repeat the process, you can do that too. I said this in my other video, I think my first one, prepping color, where I mentioned cream lighteners in hair. Most recently, this is how I've been removing my color at home. So this is Wella Professionals Blondor, and it is soft blonde oil mixed cream lightener with protective lipids and a gentle blonde result. I would use this developer 1.9%, which is 6 volume. This is Color Touch by Wella Professionals. And so I would put a ton of this and a little bit of this, mix it together, and that would be my perfect formula for removing hair color. It's really gentle because it has oil in it, so it's going to prevent the hair from getting super dried out with having oil. Yeah, so I would say that's my best advice. But if you have something like Color Oops and you think that works the best for you, just use it. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I'm gonna go let you guys click on the next one. Hope you enjoyed it. You want some real serious one-on-one hair advice? Please message me on Kylie Summers Hair on Instagram. That is my professional hair page, and I will personally guide you through your hair journey. Thanks for watching. Please leave a like because these videos are hard to edit. All right, bye guys. Stay epic.